हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स। माय सेल्फ इज ओम प्रकाश सिंह, लेक्चरर इन इंग्लिश, कुंवर सिंह इंटरमीडिएट कॉलेज बलिया। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू इंग्लिश, बट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई अपील टू all the students of the India that they will stay at home and safe in home due to COVID-19. Appealed by Honorable Prime Minister and Chief Minister, India and UP State. So I will teach you English poetry today. So it will be better for you that I will introduce about poetry. So it is essential, necessary for you that you know about poetry. First of all, I will discuss and tell you about how many poems you will read in intermediate. So it is a clear and government gazette basis या board basis, there are only 10 poem that I will teach you. Likewise, first is character of happy life, second is the true beauty, third is on his blindness, fourth poem is an elegy written in a country churchyard, fifth is a lament, sixth is lovely damsel's mercy, and seven is the passing of Arthur, 8 is my heaven, and 9 is stopping by woods on a snowy evening, and poem number 10, that is the song of the free. So it will better for you that firstly introduces about the poetry. What is poetry? It means it is my duty that I will introduce about poetry. What is poetry? So I will define you that poetry is a spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings. According to William Wordsworth, further I will explain about this poet, this learned poet William Wordsworth. He defined that poetry is a spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings. Second, learned poet H.T. Coleridge, poetry is best words in their best order. and third, according to P.B. Shelley, poetry is the expression of imagination. There are so many learned poets in the field of English literature, and they will define the definition of poetry different ways. Their opinions are very unreliable, and we will follow it. So we come on point that function of poetry. It is necessary for every student in future study the subject English literature, English subject. Function of poetry. Critics are not unanimous about the function of poetry. They hold different views. Some critics say that the main purpose of a student of poetry should be the enjoyment of poetry as poetry. Dryden says, a bare invitation will not serve the ends of poetry, which are the instruct and delight. And poetry instructs as a delight. Dr. Johnson is of the view that poetry must unite pleasure and truth. Coleridge says, if poetry instructs, it does so only through pleasure. Wordsworth also stresses that pleasure is the primary aim of poetry. His conception of pleasure is not purely aesthetic. His conception of pleasure is moral. He says that poetry aims at much higher pleasure, which results from the celebration of truth. Matthew Arnold is of the view that poetry does not portray life as it is. Rather, the poet adds something to it from his own noble nature, and this something contributes to his criticism of life. So, it will be too much clear when we come to the point that difference between poetry and prose. This is very important for every student to know about poetry. Prose is simple, but poetry is complex, subtle and sublime. Prose is dull and boring, but poetry is interesting and full of charms. Prose is objective, while poetry is chiefly subjective. Prose follows grammar, but it is not necessary in the case of poetry. Brevity is the soul of poetry. You will note in your mind that brevity is spelling, I pronounce brevity, B-R-E-V-I-T-Y, brevity is the soul of poetry, soul, S-O-U-L. So, it is also necessary for a student to know the point of elements of poetry. Point-wise, firstly, thought, emotions and imagination. So we come to the point thought. Poetry imitates life. It portrays a true picture of life. It contains the essence of truth about life and human nature, which the poet has observed and thought about. Second point, emotions and imagination. Only ideas or thoughts would not make poetry. Poetry readers relates them to emotions, then it modifies them, transforms them by the exercise of imagination. It implies reality imaginatively, colors it with emotions, but does not falsify and imprint it. Imagination and emotions are paramount in poetry. Division of poetry, personal poetry, impersonal poetry, forms of poetry. इसमें आपको पढ़ाया जाएगा लिरिक, ओड, द सॉन्ग, सोनेट. इसमें है फिर इटालियन और पैट्रिशियन सोनेट, इंग्लिश और शेक्सपियरियन सोनेट. इलिजी, द बैलड, या बैलड, द इपिक, द मॉक इपिक, रोमांस, the satire, dramatic monologue. Character, he conveys his ideas through that character. Robert Browning is the most famous poet of dramatic monologues. So, that's all. Thanks everybody.
Mm-hmm.